Hello everyone, my name is Mimamsa. In the context of the theme, Women During War, I want to talk about the book named The Unwomanly Face of the War, written by Svetlana Alexievich. She won the Nobel Prize in Literature in the year 2015. This book is a confession, a document, and a record of people's memory. Composed of voices of over 500 women describing in their own words their lives during the Soviet Union's great patriotic war against Nazi Germany. What sets this work apart is its centering women in the violence of war, not only as nurses but in other jobs which place them in the midst of carnage, including doctors, pilots, tank drivers, machine gunners, and snipers. The book gives women the right to speak. Let them tell stories about life in war. From teenage girls who grew up in wartime to the stories of girls with romantic but also tragic love, to the tearful tales of mothers, to the mother who has to kill her child. About the last line, that is, the mother who has to kill her child, I want to read this extract from the book so that we can clearly understand what the author is talking about. The extract goes like, "Somebody betrayed us. The Germans learned the location of our partisan troop. They surrounded the forest from all sides. We were hiding in the deep woods, hiding in the swamps where the torturers did not go. A radio operator was with us. She gave birth recently. The baby was hungry, wanting the breast, but the mother is starving. She has no milk, and the baby is crying. The Germans are nearby with the dogs. What if the dogs hear the baby? We are dead. All of us, 30 people. Do you understand? We make a decision. Nobody dares to tell the mother about the commander's order, but she guesses it herself. She puts the bundle with the baby into the water and holds it there for a long time. The baby does not cry, not a sound, and we cannot lift our eyes. We cannot look at the mother or at each other." What I learned after reading this book was that when women speak, they have nothing or almost nothing of what we are used to reading and hearing about. For example, I'm sure we must have read in our history books about how certain people heroically killed other people and won or lost, what equipment there was, which generals, etc., etc. But women's stories are different and about different things. In the words of the author, "Women's war has its own colors, its own smells, its own lightning, and its own range of feelings, its own words. There are no heroes and incredible feats. There are simply people doing inhumanly human things." According to me, when women go in war, they don't only have to fight the men, the outside world, but also their own warm feelings, which they need to put aside in order to protect their motherland. Imagine how unbearable and unthinkable it is to die, and how much more unbearable and unthinkable it is to kill, because a woman gives life, gives it, bears it in herself for a long time, nurses it. After reading this book, I understood that it is more difficult for women to kill. At the end, I just want to salute every woman who has went through or is going through numerous pain but still is not giving up.